At long last, schools from kindergarten to grade 12 reopened on Tuesday. Kids headed back to class after a winter break that was extended to 32 days as a precaution against COVID-19.
Our very own Stephanie Yang visited a school to see what's being done to keep kids safe.
Kids went back to school on Tuesday after their winter vacation was postponed for 2 weeks. Many of them were excited to return to school.
I want to go back to school because all my friends like to play. That's why I miss school.
Before students entered the front gate, they got their temperature checked. Only those with a normal temperature were allowed in. After that, they used an alcohol-based disinfectant on their hands. Parents, too, are pitching in to combat coronavirus. Each day before school, they have to check their children's temperature and fill out a form.
I will have them wear masks and take their temperatures every day, and then check to see if they have any signs of a cold.
This school celebrated the first day back by organizing English activities for the children. They also rolled out many public health measures. Before each class, there's a one-minute broadcast reminding children to wash their hands. There's also a checklist that every student must complete. The checklist has tasks like get a temperature reading, sanitize and wash your hands, wear a face mask, clean your chair and desk, open the windows, and more.
Outside of every classroom, there's an SOP checklist, and after a student completes the task, the teacher will give them a check mark.
Every student has to take the temperature before they get into the school campus, and then use the sanitizer prepared by school. Before they get into the classroom, front door and the back door, there will be students on duty to spray the sanitizer again to make sure their hands are clean. In our school, we have practiced quite a long time about the 1 minute notice. Inform students you have to put away every equipment and then wash your hands and then sanitize your hands.
Expert recommended these ways to lower the risk of COVID-19 transmission in schools.
To avoid poorly ventilated places, remember to wear your masks. Also, use your alcohol-based sanitizers regularly and wash your hands regularly. Before you're gonna, touch stuff, and afterwards, and also before and after you shake hands or touch other students. Before and after you touch your mouth or even rub your eyes, all these are likely methods of getting infection. So the parents can also be very watchful for their kids because sometimes maybe there are symptoms that are really masked and kids might not know they are sick. For example, you could look for extreme tiredness of kids, like loss of energy or even loss of appetite. Teachers, I would recommend that teachers and school administrators handle the medical waste, carefully, especially those tissues that students use to wipe their face.
The Ministry of Education has provided schools with masks and other supplies. They also announced class closure regulations. From kindergarten to grade 12, if one person is infected, the whole class will be sent home. Two or more infections and the whole school will close for 14 days. It's the start of a new semester, and both the government and the community are ready for battle against the coronavirus. For Formosa News, Stephanie Yang, Ling Dongming in Taipei.